Ah, who's sure? Show my edit very good.
Tiene que sanitarse. Oh, kingdom of creation, the beginning and the end of all things. We thank you for giving us the grace to come to witness the last Sunday in the month of March in 2020. We thank you for the blessings upon our lives all through this month. We thank you, God, that we are alive before by power and by divine, it is by your grace and by your mercy. We worship and adore you this morning and always, and we ask that you accept the meditations of our hearts and all the thanksgivings we have brought before you today. In our homes, we ask that you accept our hearts of worship in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, for those of us who are here and those who are watching, Father, we pray in their homes and here with us, your blessings will be resident in our lives in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray that our gathering today is not unto man, it is unto you. And we are following the scriptures that say it in all things, in all situations, we should be thanks. And so we have come to be thanks this morning. Once again, we ask that you accept our thanksgiving in the name of Jesus. Father, in all we shall do here today, in the singing of the hymns, in the reading of the psalms, in the sound that we shall hear, in the prayers that we render, Father, let us feel your presence. Father, let us feel your presence. Father, let us feel your presence in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Bless each and every one of us. Forgive our sins, O Lord. Whatever we have done that will stand against your blessings, flow into our lives. Father, we ask that the blood which we shed on the cross of Calvary will wash us clean in the name of Jesus. Sanctify our lives. Set us free from every sin. Increase your blessing on all sides of all we do. For in Jesus Christ's name, we are praying.
Amen.
The Lord's Prayer.
Service is taken from the Epistle of Paul to Romans, chapter 8, verses 6 to 14. Romans chapter 8, 6 to 14. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Because the carnal mind is enmity against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be. So then, they that are in the flesh are not please God, but ye are not in the flesh, but in the spirit. If so be that the Spirit of God dwell in you, now if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, he is none of these. And if Christ be in you, the body is dead because of sin. But the Spirit is life because of righteousness. But if the Spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also be with you. Your mortal bodies and spirit that dwelleth in you. Therefore, brethren, we are debtors, not to the flesh, to live after the flesh. For if ye live after the flesh, ye shall die. But if ye, through the Spirit, do mortify the deeds of the body, ye shall live. For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. This is the word of God.
As the prayer has to hear the message of the throne of God, we sing in 300, in 300.
Bless you all for the grace you have given to us. to be in your presence. And in the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy and there is life everlasting. Speak to us, O Lord, and let the words of my mouth and the meditation of the heart of your people be acceptable in your sight, O Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. God's power at work is what we shall consider today, and the believer's authority. God's power at work and the believer's authority. The computer dictionary describes power as the ability to act effectively. God made the world by his own power. In Jeremiah chapter 10, verse 12. By his power, the Lord raised Jesus from the dead and raised us also. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 14. Power can also be a force or a strength. Force may be used for driving a thing or for doing a work. Authority, right to act, given by law or official position, and influence or control. Power of attorney is signed official paper given to the right to act. From the beginning of creation, God has given dominion over all he created. He also gave some power to man at creation to dominate other creatures, to multiply and to decrease. The power of God at work. In the time of Eden, God was able to show to the world and to Adam and Eve what he wanted them to know and the power he gave to them. But he said to the two of them, every other thing that belongs to you, except that particular tree at the center of the garden in the fruit. But people of God, that was what Adam and Eve had to be because of the deception of the serpents. And that is why we have a problem we have in the world today, because we were asked to be the garden of peace, to face the world of pandemonium, the world of Mahu. And it's part of what we're experiencing this day with the coronavirus cycle. Since the 32 years of my ministry, this will be the first time that I'll be standing to preach like what's happened to that great prophet, Ezekiel, when he was asked to preach to the valley of the black hole. But how has it not dragons was sending him today? Because of the situation that we find ourselves in the world. God is the only one who can deliver us. No man can do it. But with God's power, the world will be delivered from the coronavirus in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And as you are listening to us in your home, we can assure that God's power will be with you, and the blessings of this service will be yours. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The power of God was demonstrated in the life of Moses when he led people, and God was able to deliver the Israelites. This same God was with the Israelites for 40 years, and they were moving away that is, neither their clothes worn out, or even the sandal. God is still to deliver only to those draws in him. The power of God delivered Joseph when his own brother sold him into slavery because of the gift that the Lord gave to him. And the same power was with the Israelites in the Red Sea. This same power was with them when he came to Jericho and the wall of Jericho and the fall that glass. The same power of God manifested when they were confronted with lies and defeated with lies. Coronavirus is the lie of the world today, but it's going to be defeated very soon in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And we already know that God has been warning us to depart from our wicked ways. treated by women and a lot of Madagascar even to the worship of God. By this time, under a normal circumstance, if you go to church in the prison, you won't find your people in the church, but you find them in the city. They'll be watching matches. But this time around, everywhere is lockdown, and nobody can watch anybody, and there's no prayer to be on the way. God is saying to the leaders of the world that he remains the ultimate power, and every power belongs to him, and he's the only one who can deliver the world. On camera, God demonstrated his power. God's power was demonstrated when he delivered Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the furnace of fire. The destruction of Haman is another power of God in action. This same God is more than able to deliver only those who trust in him. And we see a lot of miracles that Jesus performed. You see what happened in the life of Paul and Silas. They were praying, and all was working upon them. On the day of Pentecost, the power of God descended on the apostles, and they were able to speak in new tongues. And they were able to preach, and about 3,000 people gave their lives to God. God's strength was restored. God is infinitely more powerful than we man. Psalm 8, verse 3 and 4. And Isaiah 14, 15 and 17. God is able to do absolutely anything. In Jeremiah 32, verse 27, and Psalm 62, verse 11. With man, this is impossible. But with God, all things are possible. Matthew 19, verse 26. God has total power over man. Job chapter 12, verse 10. Trust in the Lord, not in your own strength. Allow God to strengthen you. Ephesians chapter 10, verse 11. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10. Be strong in the Lord and the power of his fire. God can do what you cannot do. Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6. Not by power, not by might, but by my spirit, says the Lord. By your strength shall no man prevail. 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 9b. Do what you can, but success depends on God. Nehemiah chapter 4, verse 14. Our weakness causes us to depend upon God. And this we see in Psalm 37, verse 39. The Lord is the strength. The Lord is our strength in time of trouble. So at this time in the world, when you are restricted, you can't go out of your house, you can't go to your workplace, you can't go move around because of spread of coronavirus, our God will be your strength. Our God will be your strength. Our God will be your strength. And the Lord will be with you throughout this season. And at the end of coronavirus, you are going to be counted, you and your family members. And none shall be missed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. When we have no other strength, he will strengthen us. Psalm 72, verse 12. He will give you strength day by day. All you need to do is to keep on going. And of course, he said to us in Isaiah 40:31, that people that trust in God, he will renew their strength by his. They will not, they will not retire. They will walk, they will never be weary. Give glory to the name of the Lord. We are in Lent season. And today, Lent is 28 and remaining 12 to go. And that shows to us in another 2 weeks will be in Easter. This year's Easter will be celebrated to the glory of God. With all the coronavirus, Jesus remains the answer to our problem. I will continue to pray from this altar to all of you. We pray with all of you and above the universe. Because it's the only one who can do it for us and is going to do it for us. Forget tomorrow and let tomorrow take care of itself. Matthew chapter 6, 34. just make sure that you do what you need to do, seek for the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and every other thing shall be added unto you. He will strengthen you with His power. Psalm 28:7-8. The angel of God smites the Lord because he did not give glory to God. Acts chapter 12, verses 21 to 23. Sometimes the Lord Himself wants to do the whole thing. Exodus 14:14. It says, "The battle is mine. I will fight for you and you hold your peace." The current battle belongs to our God. He's going to fight our battle and we are going to hold our peace. Our God will fight for us. What power does God be available to you and to me? You have the power to know and believe the truth. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 15 and 17. And of course, the gospel is the power of God. Romans chapter 1, verse 16. The word of the cross is foolishness to people that are perishing, but to us it is power unto victory. The power to become a child of God is given to us in John chapter 1, verse 12. He says, "He comes to his own people rejected him. But as many as believe in him, he has given them power to become sons and daughters of God." God has given you power to resist the power of every temptation. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 19. He has given you power to endure suffering and hardship, which is what we are going through all this time. And that is why Paul is issued to believe that our power is acting. He says, "In whatever situation, I've learned to be contented, being what my friends, but I know that my God will supply my needs according to His riches and glory in Christ Jesus." As you have listened to us in the house, our God will supply your needs according to His riches and glory in Christ Jesus. Beyond your own imagination, the Lord will come to your rescue. Because now Him, He says, "Let you that perish, here for the dying." Jesus is merciful. Jesus will save. Jesus will save you at His time. He will save your children at His time. He will save your kindred at His time. You can have the power to do everything, to receive eternal life will be yours. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And what are the methods that God wants you to use to have that power? Number one, there is power in the blood of Jesus. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, 18-24. Power in God's law. Ephesians chapter 3, verses 16 and 17. There is power in the scripture. Romans chapter 1, verse 16. There is power in prayer. When we pray, God will answer our prayer. There is power in associating with other Christians. Though we cannot do that for now, but very soon, people of God, we come back to the Lord and we rejoice in His presence. We continue to dance every Sunday and our joy will be fuller in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. There are people of God who say to you today that the only one that can save us is God. The only one that can deliver us is God. Let us support all the good work that we are doing in Nigeria and especially in Lagos State. Let us appreciate the work of the government of Lagos State, Baba Jideolu, Shoba, Sowolu, and let us ensure that whatever they ask us to do, we will give to them strictly. God will protect us. God will guide you. God will be with you. We shall be well with Nigeria. We shall be well with Lagos State. We shall be well with everyone that belongs to us, both now and forevermore. Shalom.
Let us thank God for the privilege he has given to us to be happy today. is not by power, is not by might. So Lord, I thank you for your grace and mercy upon me.
Jesus, 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 Jes
us pray. And gracious be for our use. Father, we have brought into your house just as you have ordered us our offerings. And we pray that you accept this offering in Jesus. Father, you accept us too in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray that you consecrate us from your word in Jesus' name. Father, we pray that you wash the whole of this world in the blood of Jesus Christ. Father, you take away this plague that is made us have this precious life. Take it away from us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And we pray that very soon we will all get together in this session to worship and glorify your holy name. Thank you, Father, for hearing us. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen.
Please be seated. We give glory and honor to God for this privilege to worship in our homes. The church is not a building for the people. Wherever you are, we are worshiping God today. We give our glory to God. For those who would like to pay their tithes, we have a trust bank account principles. Account name is Federal Church of Nigeria, OPEBI. Account number is 200-362-1097. Account number again, 200-300-362-1097. And for the payment of your offering into these accounts and other offerings. First bank account, Methodist Church Nigeria, OPEBI. Methodist Church Nigeria, OPEBI. Account number 200-263-9574. I take that again. 200-263-9574. The Lord bless you as you speak to God in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
fellows of brethren, all evil before us. And by the way, I think of my world, Baba, and you may have a world of good one, and I will not put you in that of my days. You are near seven that was seen with you are now 18 or that will be dying. The Bible, why you ever glory? The Bible, why you ever glory? As the matters ever that I want to do good people, God will know my brother, give you a little money. You want to make it on your part as you leave me. Along with me and take a good one day, make you pay with the little room, and before I do for Nelson, and before I got around to the new room, and before you come from Nelson, if there is good about my, would you allow me my river and my way in Muru, who you should go to, and I'm not you small, or I still to walk as a common head into you are, that's a common long ago, who has to be your own. Thank you.